I've entitled this video Middle East Update, but we'll get started with a little message from Scripture. Behold, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trembling unto all the people round about, when they shall be in the siege both against Judah and against Jerusalem. And in that day will I make Jerusalem a burdensome stone for all people. All that burden themselves with it shall be cut in pieces, though all the people of the earth be gathered together against it. I have some news clippings regarding the Middle East, and I want to share them with you and offer some thoughts. This week of October 3, 2011, the headlines read, If NATO attacks Syria, we'll fire missiles at Tel Aviv. Now, during a meeting, the minister of Turkey, the Syrian president Assad, threatened, If a crazy measure is taken against Damascus, I will need not more than 6 hours to transfer hundreds of rockets and missiles to the Golan Heights to fire them at Tel Aviv. Assad also stated that Damascus will call on Hezbollah to launch an intensive rocket and missile attack on Israel. All of these events will happen in 3 hours, and in the following 3 hours, Iran will attack the U.S. warships in the Persian Gulf, and the U.S. and European interests will be targeted simultaneously. Assad's comments came as the Prime Minister of Turkey said he would lay out his country's plan for sanctions against Syria after he visited a Syrian refugee camp near the border. Now, according to the UN, at least 2,700 people have been killed in the crackdown on protesters in Syria, and the demonstrators have begun to demand some sort of international protection. Now the response. Israel warns Assad, attack us, we'll hit you personally. Back in June of this year, in 2011, Israel reportedly sent messages through Turkey to Syria following intelligence reports which revealed unusual troop and missile movement. The Israeli government sent a message to the Assyrian president Assad warning him that if he started a war with the Jewish state in order to divert attention from a domestic problem, Israel will target him personally. The report added that the IDF has increased its readiness on the northern border out of fear that Hezbollah may try again to kidnap soldiers and civilians along the border. Now, this story came on the heels of another news report regarding the ongoing Iranian threat. The Iranian leader offered a simple solution to the Middle East conflict, exhorting all Israelis and Palestinians to simply go home. If the backers of the Zionist regime want to solve the issue, the solution is simple. Everyone should go home. Some poor people were brought to Palestine on the promise of security and jobs, while in turn they made the Palestinian people into refugees. So now Palestinians should go home, and those brought here should go to theirs. Once again, the Iranian leader described the Jewish state as a cancerous tumor which had to be removed to save the Middle East and the entire world. He described Israel's creation as the most heinous historical crime, and he slammed Western intolerance for debate over the Jewish state's existence. Israel has become so sanctified in the Western capitals that any criticism of the Zionist regime is tantamount to being a terrorist. The only sacred thing in Europe is the Zionist regime. A day earlier, the Supreme Leader Ayatollah Khomeini reiterated Tehran's opposition to the division of historical Palestine. Any plan that would lead to the division of Palestine is unacceptable. Any plan that would create two states would be accepting a Zionist state in the land of Palestine. Now, there's more to these reports, but I want to stop here to make comment. Regardless of what you hear on CNN or any other expert commentators, there won't be a peace. They can cobble together as many peace deals as they can, but none of them will stick. A decade ago, we heard about President Bush's roadmap to peace. Do you remember that? He was claiming there would be a free, independent Palestinian state by 2005. Well, he failed, and the plan fell completely apart. So let me ask you, is peace more likely today than a decade ago? Is the Middle East any safer? The Bible doesn't say so. The Bible says Jerusalem will be a cup of trembling, a burdensome stone to all those who get embroiled with it. Why were the Twin Towers hit? Why was the 747 taken down over Lockerbie? Why was the U.S. Marine base blown up in Beirut in 1983, where 241 U.S. servicemen died? How about the 2004 Madrid subway bombings that took the lives of almost 200 people and injured another 1,800? I mean, I can go on and on and on and give you example after example. Why is all of this happening? Because we have been entangled in this mess, and we are caught right in the middle. It's a powder keg which is on the brink. So what should we be doing? First of all, instead of peace plans and trying to meddle in places in which we have no business, we need to turn to the Bible. What does the Bible tell us? Come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers, and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself, as it were, for a little moment, until the indignation be overpassed. For, behold, the Lord cometh out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. The earth also shall disclose her blood, and shall no more cover her slain. Now some people may not know this, but the Palestinian Arabs are a Semitic people too. They are from the lineage of Abraham through his son Ishmael. If we go back to the book of Genesis, we find a story about Abraham and Sarah. Now they didn't want to wait for God to fulfill his promise, so Sarah told Abraham to take her bondservant as a concubine to produce a child. When Hagar became pregnant, Sarah got jealous. Hagar then fled into the desert. But an angel told Hagar that she was indeed with child and to return back to her mistress and submit herself to her. And the angel of the Lord said unto her, I will multiply thy seed exceedingly, that it shall not be numbered for multitude. Behold, thou art with child, and shalt bear a son, and shalt call his name Ishmael, because the Lord has heard thy affliction. And he will be a wild man, his hand will be against every man, and every man's hand against him, and he shall dwell in the presence of all his brethren. Sarah did eventually produce a son they named Isaac. So Ishmael and Isaac are then half brothers. So biblically speaking, the Palestinian Arabs, the descendants of Ishmael, have the right to live in the presence of his brethren, the descendants of Jacob Israel. The groups will somehow coexist, but there won't be a peace. Remember, he will be a wild man, his hand will be against every man, and every man's hand against him. The Middle East is probably the most militarized zone in the world. Many may disagree, but if we add up all the weaponry in the Middle East countries, plus the stockpiles of weapons stashed away by the Zionist State of Israel, and the arsenal of nuclear weapons perched, ready to be launched under the Dimona Desert, our aircraft carriers and our submarines in the Mediterranean Sea and Persian Gulf, we see it is indeed. There is more potential firepower in the region than in all the wars added up in history. A tempest is brewing, and Jerusalem is the flashpoint where the world will be thrown into turmoil. Remember, Jerusalem has been the most fought-over city in the world, and it will be until our Lord comes again. In the next video, we will see when the city of Jerusalem became the cup of trembling. Was there a point in time? Yes, there was. Why is God gathering the people to this region? And what is going to happen when war breaks out? And finally, what is the end result? So be on your toes and watchful. May God bless and guide your studies.